Okay, so here we are in the IDE. This is going to be basically the same file we had before, you know, the link class and all of the links that we make. I'm importing a new module that's built into Python called SQLite 3, and this allows us to use SQLite in Python, which is pretty cool. I've got some code here which creates an in-memory SQLite database. You can see some SQL here that we haven't discussed for creating the links table and then inserting all of the links into that table. This code isn't super important to you right now, but if you're curious, I just basically made a SQL table with all of that link data. And I've given you some instructions here. And let's play around with this a little bit. So the important thing is that we've got this DB variable, this global variable. That's going to represent our SQLite database right here. Let me show you how to run some SQL. So I can say C equals db.execute, and I can give some SQL. In this case, I'll say select star from links. And this doesn't have a where clause, like we talked about before. Where clauses aren't required. They're only required if you don't want to fetch, you know, everything. So this little bit of SQL here, select star from links, just selects all of the columns from the links table. And what this creates is what's called a cursor. And a cursor is just a position in the database. We can call this function fetch all on C on the cursor to actually load all of the data out of the database into this list of results. And in this particular case, I'll just return the results. We'll go ahead and give this a run. Woo, that's a lot of data. So we executed our SQL and we saw some results. Let's change this up a little bit. Let's change the star from a star to title. So we'll just look at the titles from the links. Let's go ahead and run this. Now we see a list of all of our titles. That's kind of cool. Let me show you some other things we can do before we have quiz time. Let's change this back to star. One of the things we can do is we can iterate over a cursor. So I can say for t in c. Okay, so I'm going to make these variables a little bit more clear. So for cursor, for link tuple, tuple's a reserved word. If we iterate over a cursor, we get the results one by one from the database. And we get them back as a tuple, not as our link object. So what we actually want to do is make the link object. So we do that, we can do that by saying this, link equals little link, you know, our little instance, equals capital link star link tuple. And this is a Python syntax for passing in all of the parameters in this tuple as arguments to this function. In this case, it's not really a function, it's the constructor link to make the object. But now we have a link object, and here I can say, let's say print link.boats. So let's go ahead and run this. What this should be doing is, so running the SQL, select star from links, iterating over all of the results that are returned to us as a tuple, converting those tuples into a link object, and then printing .votes. We can see printed all of the votes for our links. Pretty neat, eh? Let me just show you one last thing, because I'll explain what's going on here. I think this might be new to some of you. If I were just to print the link tuple like this, we'll just print exactly what we get back from the cursor. I'll show you what that does. This prints each row of the database as a Python tuple. So you can see one row here, and the columns are in order that I define them, and I conveniently define them in the same order that the constructor expects them. So you've got the ID of the link. You've got the user ID, the time it was submitted. This is an epoch time, second since 1970. This would be the number of votes, and then the title here, and the URL, okay, for each of these links. And if you put a star in front of a tuple like this and pass it into an object's constructor or any function, the arguments get put in place like that. So that's all that was happening there. And I'll show you real quick where we created this table. This is SQL. And you can see I create table links. And I've defined the columns here. ID, submitter ID, submitted time, votes, title, URL. And you can see I included the types. So anyway, that's not super important, but you know, it's there. All right, time for a quiz. So what I'd like you to do is make this query function return the number of votes that the link with ID 2 has. Now I've written some of the function for you, and all you need to do is put in the SQL here to find that link. What these other lines do is they take the cursor returned from db execute here, and runs this function called fetch one on it, which basically returns the first result. And then we use the star syntax to pass that into the link constructor, which makes a link object. And then we return link.votes. So all you have to do in this quiz is figure out the SQL. So good luck.